All right, everybody, this is Ross the Fig Boss. Today we're talking about prepping our fig trees for the spring. And you can see here on my blog, figboss.com, I've already created a blog post on this particular topic about fig tree maintenance, getting our fig trees off on the right foot. There's so much great information here that I would highly recommend you guys check this out. Use this information as a supplemental guide to this video. And I think you guys will be really better off for it. I'd also highly recommend if you guys please hit that subscribe button right now, hit that like button right now. It really helps out these videos that I make. So in terms of actually prepping our fig trees for the spring and doing maintenance on our fig trees, a lot of that is a very critical task in the spring. And I would highly recommend that all of you guys do a lot of these steps, if not all of them in this video, because all the things that we can do now, the little things that we can do now, add up to mountains later on in the season. And that's what we call an exponential gain, right? So these little things now show itself later on in the season in such a big way. And so by doing things now, we can have more fruits, earlier to ripen fruits, and just typically better tasting fruits. So I would highly recommend that you guys do all of this that I'm gonna mention. The first thing I think is really critical to understand is that in the spring, the fig tree is one of the last trees to wake up. And so you may find it to be your benefit, especially for us in short season climates, to wake these fig trees up prematurely, to help them wake up. And the ways that you can help them wake up is about warming the soil and rehydrating the roots. So we just want to give our fig trees a nice watering, really nice and moist, saturate that soil, and then of course try to help them wake up with some extra soil temperatures. Now for me, I have them here, a lot of them planted against the house. That's as good as they get. Also planting them in warmer soil, planting them in a western or southern exposure. But if we have fig trees in containers, this is definitely where I think you can impact them the most by waking them up with something like a greenhouse. And so this greenhouse, all the extra little heat units, all the extra little soil temperatures add up exponentially down in the season. So if we can get them awake by using a greenhouse, I have a little small space heater in here. This goes a long way. Instead of having my figs ripen by August 1st, these are ripening by July 1st, pretty consistently. So that's a whole month earlier to get figs to ripen of just the main crop that we're talking about there. You can also construct things like low tunnels here. I have, for this bed of young fig trees, I've constructed tunnels over top of this, and I will be doing that again this year. And that's another great way to warm up the soil. If you don't want to have a whole greenhouse like this that's more permanent, put down a low tunnel that's easily moved and easily put up and easily taken down every single season. One of the bigger things I think with waking them up is that, again, some of the trees can just be stubborn. And so if you have that last frost date coming and you still have trees that are not awake, it's, again, highly in your benefit to wake them up prematurely. Do some things to try to encourage them to wake up. Again, some of these trees are just stubborn. And so that heat unit, every little degree of soil temperature adds up way later in the season. So that's why we do things like we plant them up higher above grade. We plant them in full sun or in the warmest spot in our yards. And that always gets us the results that we want year after year from the beginning. If you want to transplant some figs or you want to plant them, this is a great time to do that. So think about the spring or the fall or the winter time, depending on where you guys live, getting them acclimated now is your best bet. You want to avoid that summer heat to do the transplanting or to do them, to plant them in the ground like this. I would recommend planting them from a 2 gallon size pot, stick them in the ground, and then apply lots of mulch. That's the key little critical thing there. That mulch is going to help conserve water, help them get established quicker, and you're going to have more of those microbes in the soil as time goes on. And that's obviously very important for the health of our trees. One of the other things I think we ought to pay attention to is propagation. So if we want to do some pruning now at this point, it's very simple. Just take some cuttings off of our tree and you can root them. Now that the temperatures are getting closer to 78 degrees Fahrenheit, that's the best time to be doing any kind of propagation for our fig trees, whether that's layering. And there's so many different forms of propagation that I've also included on the blog, figboss.com. go there, check out that article, but there's different types of layering. You could do grafting, and you can also do rooting. When the temperatures of the soil and the air are closer to 78 degrees Fahrenheit, that's when you see the best success rates with propagation. Now, pruning though is pretty critical for this time of the year, because maybe we want to do some last minute pruning. Maybe you didn't even do your pruning yet. Some people do their pruning in the fall and the winter time. Definitely the spring is that last call for pruning. And it's a great idea to do that because you want to get that form right going into the season. Just like the extra soil temperatures that I mentioned, having the right form goes a long way towards exponential gains down at the end of the season. So if we have things like dead branches, disease branches, crisscrossing branches, branches growing in the wrong place, in general, you have a very shaded tree or a very condensed, you know, tree that just has a lot of branches in there very close together, you may want to consider doing some pruning. Now, for me, I'm a big proponent, as some of you guys know, instead of pruning, I really like to do staking. And so I do this to every single tree, every single spring. It is probably the most important topic of this video, is actually doing staking. And so this is an example here of a Rondé Bordeaux that I wrapped this winter. I actually pruned it in the fall, then we wrapped it, we brought all the branches together, and so now a lot of the branches are very close together. Rather than what they looked like actually in the spring, the branches were rather spread out. But now I've brought them in close on purpose to protect them. And so now the key thing here is to re-put them back to where they were. Put them on an angle so that they're open like this, rather than straight up in the air. If you think about branches that are straight up in the air, they just are accessing less light and they're shading out the other parts of the tree. So by putting them on an angle, I now have access to the sunlight over here, whereas before I only had access to sunlight here. And now this sunlight is now kind of shading whatever is behind it. So doing the staking is absolutely critical to actually get the form that you want. Every fig tree is different. Every fig tree grows in a slightly different way. And the other key thing here with staking is that I would rather stake than prune. So I could, as an example, prune away a branch that was growing in the wrong location, let's say. But now, if I just stake it, I can preserve this wood here. I can preserve these apical and lateral buds, and I'll show you that in the greenhouse with the trees that are awake. These apical and lateral buds have such an easier time fruiting. They also fruit at an earlier date, and they ripen typically higher quality fruit because of that. So if we have branches here, we look at some of these trees, and these buds are absolutely critical to preserve. See these buds right here? We even have figs that are forming, brevas they're called, that's the first crop. But these apical buds, the higher points on our tree, these are the buds that we want to preserve. The same thing here down below is a lateral bud. And so if we can preserve as many of these buds as possible, again, we're going to have success. So rather than pruning that away, I would rather preserve it and just stake it. Just put it on an angle or put it away from something and have it grow in the right location. Now, if you need to prune your tree for health, you can. And so that's obviously something to consider, is that if we're going to be doing pruning, it's about either first and foremost improving the health of our tree or the form of our tree. But beyond that, we should just be focusing on staking. Now, one of the other things I get asked a lot about is fertilizer. And so fertilizer is not really the thing that's going to give us fruits. In fact, it's actually the light that I was just talking about. Having the right form is really what sets the fruits on our tree. So a lot of people have, you know, let's say very healthy trees. They look beautiful, they're big, they're bushy, and they always message me and they say, Ross, my fig tree is in great shape, but it just doesn't fruit. Why is that? And it's always just a lack of light. By removing some of that density in the canopy, you're going to be way better off. By opening up the tree and putting it more on an angle, it's not about the water, it's not about the fertilizer. Obviously, we need good health, and that's what those two things connect to. But most of us have a very healthy fig tree, especially in the ground. But in the ground, we may want to apply some fertilizer, in fact. And the spring is the best time to be doing your fertilizing, We want to stick to a consistent schedule if we're doing that, especially for the containers. The in-ground trees, though, I'd highly recommend you guys get yourself a soil test. Correct any deficiencies immediately. If you're using an NPK fertilizer, for me, I like a 20-10-20. And then other nutrients that I think are highly recommended, you may want to apply this to most of your fig trees, are things like minerals and trace minerals. So things like magnesium, calcium, sulfur, silica, a lot of the trace minerals, boron, potassium in higher amounts, I think goes a long way. All these nutrients I think are specific to fig trees in that I think they do require them a bit more than others. So get yourself a really well-balanced fertilizer that covers most of those nutrients. Get yourself green sand or rock dust to cover the micronutrients, or apply things like mulch. These wood chips break down and apply plenty of minerals to the soil, and of course have so many other functions to it. You could also get yourself lime or gypsum or oyster shell or diatomaceous earth. Silica, I think, is a really underrated one. Help your soil out a little bit and give it some silica. That really improves the health of our fig trees. So that's fertilizer. I don't think it's the biggest deal, but certainly in the spring, if we can apply the right nutrients, if we are deficient, we need nutrients in the soil, that has an exponential effect, as I mentioned, with the heat later down in the season. The same thing with light. If we get the right light, the right heat, the right fertilizer, and also now the right water, if we do all these things right, we're gonna have an exponential benefit later down in the season. So the last thing I think we wanna talk about is the water. In the spring, we want to really hydrate these roots, as I mentioned, to actually get these fig trees awake. But we also want to be helping them grow. By giving them more of this water in the spring, that's the key critical time for them to grow. After they have set their fruits in the main crop, then we can slow down the water. We're not necessarily too concerned at that point with having an excess of water. But that water helps them grow and then allows them to actually put out more fruits that particular season. So getting them in this stage here where it's all about growth to get to that point where they do fruit, and that's where we can maximize the number of fruits that we have for that particular season. Some of the other things you may want to concern yourself with, and just the last little thing here, is actually weed control. You can see some weeds down here or grasses that I have in the yard or in this planting here. Get all those up, get them out of your containers. You don't need that unnecessary competition. And then the last thing we'll mention is something called scale. So we'll talk about pest control, and scale is really the number one thing here. Scale can definitely come up from the base of your trees and crawl up the tops of the trees and kind of hide in these crevices and cracks, and they can suck the sap of your tree. Any tree, and they can, if high in number, definitely cause a problem for your fig tree that season. So it's my recommendation, just go across all your trees, maybe get a brush or even use your hand and wipe them off. Learn how to identify them. There's three stages of them. And the worst part about it is that if you have scale, they leave behind this residue from sucking the sap of your tree that ants love. And so then ants crawl up and down your trees. And then by the time the season comes for them to actually ripen, you have ants all over your tree and they're devouring the figs and as well as the residue left behind the scale. So get rid of the scale, and that will eliminate a lot of your problems. You can use neem, dormant oil, even tanglefoot. But for me, I think the best thing here is just to rely a little bit on ladybugs and also just use your hand here or a brush to kind of get them off, especially in these cracks and crevices that they may be hiding. So that's it there, guys. Thanks for watching this one. Again, check out the blog, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button for me. We'll see you guys for the next one here. Take care, everybody.